This conference will now be recorded.
Good morning, students. Last class we started this dynamic equation of gradually varied flow. In unit 2, this is the most important concept. Definitely in the examinations also you will get the questions from this dynamic equation of gradually varied flow. Last class I explained this dynamic equation of gradually varied flow. Since it is an important concept, I am going to revise this concept again. Please everyone follow this revision carefully. So in gradually varied flow, we know that in gradually varied flow, the depth of water surface gradually changes. Since the depth of water surface gradually changes, in gradually varied flow, the water surface is not parallel to the channel bottom. In uniform flow, the channel bottom, the water surface, and the total energy line are parallel to each other. In uniform flow, S0 equal to SW equal to SF. Because in uniform flow, depth of flow is constant. So in uniform flow, the channel bottom, the water surface, and the total energy line parallel to each other. But in gradually varied flow, the depth of flow changes along the length of channel. Since that depth of flow is changing, in gradually varied flow, the water surface is not parallel to the channel bottom. So in order to study the nature of water surface in gradually varied flow, we need an equation that is called dynamic equation of gradually varied flow. So the purpose of this dynamic equation of gradually varied flow is to study the nature of the water surface profile in the gradually varied flow. What is that slope of the gradually varied flow water surface profile? To study that slope of water surface profile in gradually varied flow, we need an equation that is called the dynamic equation of gradually varied flow. So to understand the nature of water surface profile, the dynamic equation is required in the gradually varied flow in open channel. So last class I explained this derivation completely. Please go through the derivation carefully. To discuss this dynamic equation in gradually varied flow, we consider the gradual varied water flow in the open channel. So in this image, the water flow in the channel is gradually varied flow, not the uniform flow. This is the top water level. We call this top water level as the water surface profile in this open channel. Since it is gradually varied flow, the depth of flow is changing along this channel bottom. So with respect to this channel bottom, in the gradually varied flow, the depth of flow continuously changing. So in gradually varied flow, the water surface profile is not parallel to the channel bottom. So we are going to discuss what is the slope of this water surface profile in this gradually varied flow by using the equation called the dynamic equation of gradually varied flow. To discuss the dynamic equation, we consider the datum line horizontally. With respect to the datum line, at a particular section in this water flow, in this open channel, at a particular section, let Z is the potential head, Y is the pressure head, V square by 2Z is the kinetic head. So at this section, the total energy of water flow is Z plus Y plus V square by 2Z along this length of the channel. So along this length of the channel, that length is with respect to this bottom of the channel. Along this length of the channel, this Z is changing, Y is changing, velocity V also changing. So along this length of the channel, the total energy is also changing. So the total energy of water flow in this gradually varied flow is z plus y plus v square by 2z, that is changing along this length of the channel. Before going to discuss the derivation of dynamic equation, first we must discuss the assumptions made in this derivation of dynamic equation. Already I explained the first assumption. We consider the channel size is constant throughout the length of channel, that is called prismatic channel. Second assumption, the channel bottom slope, that is S naught or I. The channel bottom slope is very, very small. Then in the gradually varied flow with slight modifications, we can apply the Chezy's equation and also the Manning's equation to find out the velocity of water flow. In uniform water flow, the Chezy's equation is V is equal to C root RI. V is equal to C root RI, that is the Chezy's equation in uniform flow. In that equation, I is channel bottom slope, that is also S naught. So in uniform flow, the Chezy's equation is the velocity V is equal to C root R into S naught. Whereas in gradually varied flow, the velocity of water flow is given by V is equal to C root R into SF. That is the third assumption we assume in the determination of the velocity of water flow in gradually varied flow. We consider the slope of the total energy line SF, not the slope of the channel bottom. That is the third assumption. So in this gradually varied flow, the Chezy's equation becomes as V is equal to C root R into SF, and also the Manning's equation becomes as V is equal to 1 by N R power 2 by 3 SF power half. This is the third assumption. So with minor modifications, instead of the channel bottom slope S naught, in the gradually varied flow, we consider the slope of the total energy line SF in the Chezy's equation and also in Manning's equation. The fourth assumption, in the dynamic equation, we assume the kinetic energy factor alpha is equal to 1. The fifth assumption, the pressure distribution along the depth of water from top to the channel bottom. Along the depth of water, the pressure distribution is assumed as hydrostatic. The last assumption, in this dynamic equation derivation, we assume the roughness coefficient of channel bottom, F, is independent of depth of flow Y, and it is considered as constant throughout the length of the channel. These are the assumptions made in the derivation of dynamic equation of gradually varied flow. Please remember, dynamic equation is helpful to understand the water surface slope, water surface profile slope in the gradually varied flow. Now, please everyone follow this derivation of dynamic equation carefully. So we consider the gradually varied flow in the open channel. Check this image on your cell phones. We consider the gradually varied flow in the open channel. So in this image, the channel bottom slope is S naught. The total energy line slope is SF. We are going to discuss what is the equation of the slope of the water surface profile, the top level of water. This is called water surface profile, top level of water. What is the equation of the slope of water surface profile in the gradually varied flow? If this water flow is uniform, then we indicate the water surface profile slope as SW. In the uniform flow, S naught equal to SW equal to SF. But it is gradually varied flow, so the depth of flow, the depth of water flow changing along this length of the channel. So we consider the gradually varied flow in this open channel, and we consider the datum line, our general datum line. With respect to the datum line, at a particular section, Z is the potential head, Y is the pressure head, V square by 2Z is the kinetic head. So at this section, the total energy of water flow is plus y plus v square by 2z. So that is the total energy of water flow at this section. But this total energy is not constant. It is changing along this length of the channel. So along this length of the channel at the channel bottom, along this length of the channel, z is changing, y is changing, v square by 2z also changing. So this total energy is also changing along this length of the channel. So in this dynamic equation derivation, we consider this length of the channel at the channel bottom. So I consider that x-axis. X-axis indicates the length of the channel considered at this channel bottom. So we first calculate the total energy of water flow at this section. H is equal to z plus y plus v square by 2z. Now that H is not constant, so differentiate this total energy. Differentiate this total energy with respect to this length of the channel. The length of this channel is considered the channel bottom, that is taken as x. The length of the channel is considered as x. That length of the channel is measured at the channel bottom. So differentiate this total energy with respect to the length of the channel, because the total energy is changing along this length of the channel. Now check this diagram. Along this length of the channel, this z is also changing. This z value is also changing along the length of the channel. This depth y also changing along the length of the channel. Velocity is also changing along the length of the channel. So the kinetic energy is also changing along the length of the channel. We know that this velocity v is equal to discharge divided by area A, wetted area A. So v is equal to q by A. This is v is equal to q by A, discharge by area. Substitute this v is equal to q by A in this equation. The total energy becomes as h is equal to z plus y plus q square by 2z A square. So that is the equation of the total energy of water flow in the gradually varied condition at a particular section. H is equal to y plus z plus y plus q square by 2z A square. Consider the discharge q as constant. Take the discharge of water flow in the channel as constant. Then look at that right hand side in this equation. In this right hand side, z, it is the datum head. It is changing with respect to length of the channel at channel bottom. That is not constant. Y is the depth of flow, changing along the length of the channel. A is the wetted area, also changing along the length of the channel. So differentiate this total energy equation with respect to length x of the channel at the channel bottom. So dh by dx, that x is the length of the channel at the channel bottom. So to prepare the dynamic equation, differentiate this equation with respect to the length x measured along the channel bottom. So we are going to differentiate that total energy, that is dh by dx. Here x is the length of the channel measured at the channel bottom. Dh by dx equal to d by dx of the total energy is z plus y plus q square by 2z A square. So this first term dz by dx. In the gradually varied flow, the z is changing with respect to length x. So dh by dx is not equal to 0, because this z value changing along the length of the channel. So it is dz by dx plus the depth y is also changing along the length of the channel. So the second term is dy by dx. The third term, q is constant. Discharge is constant, 2z is constant. So take this q square by 2z outside the differentiation. So the third term is q square by 2z into d by dx of 1 by a square. A is the wetted area. The wetted area is changing along this length x. So differentiate this d by dx of 1 by a square carefully. D by dx of 1 by a square is minus 2 by a cube into dA by dx, that is this value. D by dx of 1 by a square, minus 2 by a cube into dA by dx. So this differentiation dH by dx equal to dz by dx plus dy by dx minus q square by 2z into 2 by a cube into dA by dx. Cancel these two in the third term on right side. So this equation becomes as dH by dx equal to dz by dx plus dy by dx minus q square by ga cube into dA by dx. So in this dynamic equation, we differentiate the total energy H with respect to the length of the channel X measured at the channel bottom. From this differentiation, dH by dx, we got this equation 1. dH by dx equal to dz by dx plus dy by dx minus q square by ga cube into dA by dx. Now, what is this dH by dx in equation 1? We are going to discuss these terms dH by dx, dz by dx, dy by dx. What is this dH by dx? dH is the change in total energy for the length dx. That is the meaning of dH by dx. So in this left hand side, dx is the length of the channel at the channel bottom. dH is the change in total energy over the length dx. So everyone please watch this. So here, this is the total energy line. The total energy is changing along the length of the channel. If the total energy is constant, the total energy is a horizontal line. But here the total energy is a inclined line, downwards inclined. So this inclined total energy indicates the total energy is changing along the length of the channel. So for the length dx, dx is the length of the channel measured at channel bottom. So for this length dx of the channel, the change in total energy is dh, because the total energy is changing along the length of the channel. Check this line, everyone, carefully. This is the total energy line, inclined line. The total energy line is inclined because the total energy is changing along the length of the channel. If the total energy is constant, then this total energy line is horizontal. But this total energy line is inclined line, that indicates the total energy is changing along the length of the channel. So in this inclined line, for the length dx, for this length dx of the channel, say dh is the change in the total energy. So this ratio dh by dx indicates the slope of this total energy line, that is equal to sf. So in this diagram, dh by dx, the change in total energy for the length dx of channel measured at the channel bottom, dH by dx is equal to sf. But this total energy line is in downward direction. The total energy line sloping downwards, not upwards. Since this total energy line is sloping downwards, dH by dx equal to minus sf. That negative indicates the total energy line is sloping downwards. So this ratio dH by dx equal to minus sf. What is this dz by dx? Check this diagram. Along this length of the channel, the height z is also changing. This is the channel bottom slope, sloping bottom. The channel bottom is a sloped bottom. Since the channel bottom is a sloped bottom, this vertical height z changes along the length of the channel. If the channel bottom is horizontal, the z is constant throughout the length. But here the channel bottom is sloped bottom. So this z is changing along this length of the channel. For the length dx of the channel, say dz is the change in height of this channel bottom from the datum line. For this length dx, that dz is the change in height of the channel bottom. So this ratio dz by dx is equal to the channel bottom slope s naught. Here also the channel bottom slope is a downward slope. So dz by dx is equal to minus s naught. So from this diagram we can understand dh by dx is the slope of the total energy line minus sf, because it is sloping downward. Dz by dx is the slope of the channel bottom minus s naught. What is this dy by dx? Y indicates the depth of water flow with respect to channel bottom. We measure this depth y with respect to this channel bottom, that is this depth of flow y. In the gradually varied flow, the depth of flow changing along the length of the channel. In uniform flow, the depth y is constant, but here the flow is gradually varied flow, the depth y changing along this length of the channel. So for the length dx of the channel, measured at a channel bottom, let dy is the change in depth of water flow. So check this carefully. For the length dx of the channel measured at a channel bottom, take dy is the change in depth of water flow. So dy by dx is called the slope of this water surface profile, the slope of the water surface profile with respect to channel bottom. Because we measure this distance dx along the channel bottom, so we call this dy by dx as the slope of the water surface profile with respect to channel bottom. So the water surface profile slope is dy by dx. This is the slope of the water surface profile with respect to the channel bottom. So in that equation 1, please check everyone, in this equation 1, dh by dx is equal to the slope of the total energy line minus sf, dz by dx equal to the slope of the channel bottom minus s naught, dy by dx is equal to the slope of the water surface profile with respect to channel bottom. So in that equation 1, everyone follow this, in that equation 1, dh by dx, the slope of the total energy line with respect to channel bottom, because we measure this distance dx with respect to channel bottom. So dh by dx is the slope of the total energy line or the energy gradient line with respect to channel bottom minus sf, dz by dx equal to the slope of the channel bed or the channel bottom minus s naught. This negative indicates the total energy line sloping downward, the channel bottom also sloping downward. And dy by dx is called the slope of the water surface profile with respect to channel bottom, because we measure this distance dx along the channel bottom. Dz by dx is called the slope of the water surface profile with respect to channel bottom. Then in the equation 1, we have this q square by ga cube into dA by dx. Observe this dA by dx in this equation 1. We are going to modify this dA by dx slightly. So check that modification of dA by dx here. So dA by dx is equal to, we are modifying this dA by dx as dA by dy into dy by dx. So slightly modify this dA by dx differentiation. dA by dx is equal to dA by dy into dy by dx. In unit 1, in the concept of specific energy and critical depth, we discussed that specific energy and critical depth in unit 1. So in that critical depth and specific energy, we discussed about this dA by dy. I explained in the specific energy and critical depth in unit 1, this dA by dy ratio. So please go through that unit 1. Already I uploaded the PDF copy of unit 1 in the WhatsApp group, second year WhatsApp group. Open that PDF copy and check the specific energy and critical depth in unit 1. In that specific energy critical depth, I explained this dA by dy value. In the open channels, this dA by dy is equal to the top width of open channel. This value of dA by dy equal to top width t. So here on the right side, d dA by dy equal to top width t into dy by dx. You know that this dy by dx is the slope of water surface profile with respect to channel bottom. So this dA by dx, this value of dA by dx equal to t, that is dA by dy, top width, dA by dy is top width. So dA by dx equal to t into dy by dx. Substitute this dA by dx is equal to t into dA by dy by dx in equation 1. The equation 1 becomes as, in the equation 1, the left hand side dH by dx, dH by dx equal to minus SF, that is the slope of the total energy line, dH by dx minus SF. On the right side, first term, dz by dx, that is the slope of the channel bottom minus S0. The second term, dy by dx, this is the slope of the water surface profile with respect to channel bottom minus third term, q square by ga cube into dA by dx. But dA by dx equal to t into dy by dx. So substitute on equation 1, you will get that equation 1, minus SF equal to minus S0 plus dy by dx minus q square by ga cube into t into dy by dx. Take this minus S0 to the left hand side, it becomes plus S0. So this equation modifies as S0 minus SF equal to S0 minus SF equal to dy by dx, this remaining right hand portion, dy by dx minus q square by ga cube into t into dy by dx. Take this dy by dx common on the right side, this equation becomes as dy by dx into 1 minus q square t by ga cube into is equal to S0 minus SF. So take the dy by dx on the right side common. So the previous equation becomes as dy by dx into 1 minus q square t by ga cube equal to S0 minus SF. From this, dy by dx equal to S0 minus SF divided by 1 minus q square t by ga cube. So in this equation, dy by dx is the slope of the water surface profile with respect to channel bottom, SF. SF is the slope of the total energy line with respect to channel bottom. S0 is the slope of the channel bottom. Q is discharge of water flow in the channel. T is the top width of channel. A is the wetted area of channel. Slightly modify this denominator, Q square T by GA cube. Slightly modify this denominator, Q square T by GA cube. Separate in this denominator a cube as a square into a. Separate this a cube as a square into a. So this equation q square t by ga cube is modified as q square by ga square into t by a. So separate this a cube as a square into a. Then modify this q square t by ga cube as q square divided by ga square into t by a. Q square by a square, discharge by area is velocity. So q square by a square is v square divided by z into t by a. T by a is 1 by d. D is called hydraulic depth. Hydraulic depth d equal to wetted area by top width t. So t by a is equal to 1 by d. So this q square t by ga cube is equal to v square by g into d. In open channels, the Froude number fr equal to v divided by root gd. That is the definition of Froude number in open channel, but it is v square by gd, that is equal to fr square. So this v square by gd is the Froude number square, fr square. So q square t by ga cube is equal to fr square. Substitute this fr square in this previous equation. This equation becomes as dy by dx equal to s0 minus sf divided by 1 minus fr square, equation 2. So check this equation 2. So by modifying this q square t by ga cube as fr square, we modify this equation, that is dy by dx equal to s0 minus sf divided by 1 minus fr square, equation 2. In equation 2, dy by dx, it is the slope of water surface profile with respect to channel bottom in gradually varied flow. You know that in gradually varied flow, the depth of water flow changing along the length of channel. Once the depth of water flow changing means sometimes the depth of water flow increases along the length of the channel. Sometimes the depth of water flow decreases along the length of the channel. If the depth of water flow increases along the length of the channel, this slope dy by dx is taken as positive. So we consider this slope dy by dx as positive if the depth of water flow increases along the length of the channel in downward direction. If the depth of water flow decreases along the length of the channel in downward direction, dy by dx is taken as negative. So in this equation 2, dy by dx is the slope of the water surface profile with respect to channel bottom. We call this equation 2 as the dynamic equation of gradually varied flow. So we call the equation 2 as the dynamic equation of gradually varied flow. In that equation 2, dy by dx indicates the slope of the water surface profile with respect to channel bottom. So check these slopes carefully. Please watch this slide on your cell phones. Here in this image, the first one, along this length of the channel, along the length of the channel, the depth of water flow gradually increasing. Since the depth of flow gradually increasing, it is a gradual varied flow. But here, the depth of flow is increasing gradually along the direction of water flow. So in the direction of water flow, downward direction, if the depth of flow gradually increases, then the water surface profile slope is taken as positive. Whereas in this Samudra diagram, along this length of the channel, that is along the direction of water flow, depth of water flow gradually decreasing. If the depth of water flow gradually decreasing in the direction of water flow, then the slope of this water surface profile dy by dx is taken as negative. So like that, the slope dy by dx is positive if the depth of water flow gradually increases. The slope dy by dx is negative if the depth of water flow gradually decreases. So this is the discussion on the dynamic equation of gradually varied flow. So if anybody is having doubt up to this derivation of dynamic equation, please discuss with me. Up to that derivation of dynamic equation, dy by dx equal to s naught minus sf divided by 1 minus fr squared. If anybody is having doubt in the derivation of dynamic equation in gradually varied flow, please discuss with me. Any doubts in the dynamic equation? Please give me the response. Any doubt in the dynamic equation? Is my voice audible to you? Please give me the response. Is my voice audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Can you hear my voice clearly? Any doubt,
yes, sir,
in
audible.
Dynamic equation
audible.
Derivation? Any doubt in the dynamic equation derivation? Any doubt in the dynamic equation derivation? Otherwise, post your doubts on the chat box. If you are unable to speak, post your doubts on the chat box. If you don't have doubts, give me the response. Lateral entry Sivakumar is there on the class? Lateral entry Sivakumar 103. Please give me the response, otherwise I'll put the absent. Lateral entry Sivakumar.
Sir,
Any doubts, Sukumar, in the dynamic equation?
All doubts, sir.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Sukumar. Then lateral entry 107. Who is that? Lateral entry 107.
Yes, sir. Sir Sheikh Mujib, sir.
Pradeep, is there any doubt on this dynamic equation?
Sir, no doubt, sir.
Thank you. Raja, 147, regular. Shaik Raja, are you there in the class? Raja, are you there in the class? Shaik Raja. Give me the response. Are you there in the class? Otherwise, you will get the absent. It seems you are there in the class. It is indicating that you are there in the class, Raja. Please give me the response. Not 124, please. 147. 147, Raja. Are you there in the class? It seems Raja is not attending the class. So please inform him. Today he will get the absent for my class. Then Tarun Reddy, 128. Tarun Reddy, give me the response. Are you there in the class? Tarun Reddy, are you there in the class or out of line? 128, Tarun Reddy. So if you are not giving the response, you will get the absent. So you are attending the class, putting the cell phone outside. You are doing your own business. Okay, coming to the regular 120. Roll number 120. Regular. 19G21A0120. Are you there in the class? Give me the response. Roll number 120. Is it audible, my voice? Roll number 120. Please, others don't respond. Roll number 120. Is it audible, my voice? Give me the response. Since it is below 12 o'clock, so they must have some work outside. After 12, anyhow, we are in lockdown. We must be in the houses. But it is 120 before 12 o'clock. Some of them are outside. And regular 115. Regular 115. Are you there in the class? Regular 115. Give the response. Are you there in the class? Give me the response. And 118.
Sir, sir.
Thank you. Any doubts? 118.
No, sir.
Okay, thank you. What about Tarun Reddy? 127 and Shaik Raja, 120, 147. Number of times I warned you, this is the most difficult subject in your second BTech second semester. You must concentrate on this subject. At least if you pass this subject in second semester, it is well and good. That difficult subject is hydraulic engineering. Most of your seniors, after the completion of their fourth year also, most of your seniors are still writing the supplementary in this hydraulic engineering. This is that much difficult subject. But why these people are so neglected in this class? Inform to Shaikh Raja, the class CR, please inform to Shaikh Raja, make a call to me. Otherwise, today he will get the absent. This is not the way to attend the class. Just cutting the class, putting the cell phone on the other side and doing their own business. If you do like that, I will complete this unit rule within 5 minutes. If the process is like this, I will complete this unit 2 within 5 minutes. I know. I won't take this much bother, this much pain. I know how to complete the syllabus. Within 5 minutes, I will complete the unit 2. Why you people are so neglected in this class? We are taking lot of pain to prepare these notes, to prepare this PPT for you only, not for us. But still, most of you are so neglecting in the class. The class CR, please inform to Tarun Reddy and Shaikh Raja to make a phone call to me before the completion of my class. Otherwise, they will get the absent. Dear CR of this class, please inform. Who is the CR of this class? Second year, second semester, who is the class representative?
Jay Krishna.
Jay Krishna, are you there in the class? Jay Krishna, are you there in the class?
Sir, yes, sir.
You please inform to Shaikh Raja and Tarun Reddy to make the call to me. Otherwise,
yes,
definitely they will get the option in the today's class. I already posted this in the group.
Yes, sir.
Now coming to this dynamic equation. Please everyone understand this dy by dx carefully. This dy by dx is the slope of the water surface with respect to channel bottom. Please don't confuse. Here this dy by dx is the slope of the water surface with respect to channel bottom. Please check these images. Here this channel bottom is also inclined channel bottom. The channel bottom is not horizontal with respect to that inclined channel bottom. So please everyone understand this dy by dx clearly. Dy by dx is the slope of the water surface with respect to the channel bottom. The channel bottom is also inclined channel bottom. So in this image, this dy by dx, the slope of the water surface with respect to inclined channel bottom. This is the water surface profile. In the dynamic equation, we prepare this dy by dx. Dy by dx equal to s naught minus sf divided by 1 minus fr square. In the dynamic equation, that dy by dx indicates the slope of the water surface, that is the top water level. We call this as water surface profile. So dy by dx is the slope of the water surface profile with respect to channel bottom. But sometimes, please listen carefully, but sometimes we must also express the slope of this water surface profile with respect to horizontal, we must also express the slope of this water surface profile. Now we are going to discuss what is the slope of the water surface profile with respect to horizontal in the gradually varied flow. So please catch this carefully, everyone. Don't confuse. It is a totally confusing concept. For you, it is totally confusing concept. In the dynamic equation, dy by dx indicates. In the dynamic equation, dy by dx indicates the slope of the water surface or water surface profile with respect to channel bottom. The channel bottom is inclined channel bottom. So with respect to this inclined channel bottom, the slope of this water surface profile indicated as dy by dx. Now we are going to discuss what is the slope of the water surface profile with respect to horizontal, not with respect to this inclined channel bottom. With respect to inclined channel bottom, the slope of the water surface profile is dy by dx. Then what is the slope of this water surface profile with respect to horizontal, The slope of this water surface profile indicated as SW. So please catch these points carefully. With respect to horizontal, the slope of this water surface profile in the open channel in gradually varied flow is indicated as SW. So this water surface profile is having two types of slopes. The water surface profile in gradually varied flow in open channel is having two slopes. One is dy by dx. dy by dx is called the slope of this water surface profile in the gradually varied flow with respect to channel bottom. The channel bottom is inclined channel bottom. Then the other slope of this water surface profile is SW. SW is the slope of this water surface profile in the gradually varied flow with respect to horizontal. So for this water surface profile, we have two types of slopes. One is dy by dx with respect to inclined channel bottom. Next one is SW with respect to horizontal. We are going to discuss now what is the relationship between dy by dx slope, SW slope, and the slope S naught. So in the next concept, after the completion of this dynamic equation, I am going to explain you the differences, the relation between the three types of slopes. Before that discussion, just now we completed that dynamic equation in gradually varied flow. Now please watch this important concepts, important notes. After this dynamic equation, the third important point is, the first point is the positive water slope. So when the water surface rising, when this water surface, the depth of water surface or water flow increasing in the direction of water flow, the slope is considered as positive, the first point. If the depth of water flow decreasing along the length of the channel in the direction of water flow, the water surface slope is negative slope. Then in the gradually varied flow, so check these points carefully, the third and fourth point. If the water flow is uniform in the open channel, in unit 1 we discuss, in the uniform water flow, the Chesis equation, if the water flow in the open channel is uniform flow, the discharge of that uniform water flow according to Chesis equation, Q is equal to A into velocity V, that is A into C root Ri. This is the uniform water flow Chesis equation, and this I is equal to bottom slope S naught. According to Manning's equation, in uniform water flow, the discharge of water flow Q is equal to 1 by N wetted area A into R power 2 by 3 I power half, that is equal to 1 by N area A R power 2 by 3 S naught power half. These are the equations for the discharge of water flow if the water flow in the open channel is uniform flow. But the other condition is non-uniform flow or the varied flow. In that, we have gradually varied flow. So what is the equation of discharge of water flow in the gradually varied flow in open channel? If the water flow in the open channel is gradually varied flow, according to Chesis equation, the discharge of water flow is given by Q is equal to AC into root R into SF. In the uniform flow, it is S naught. In the gradually varied flow, this is SF. SF is the slope of the total energy line. So observe the differences between the uniform flow discharge equations and the gradually varied flow discharge equations. In the gradually varied flow in open channel, the discharge of water flow according to Chesis equation Q is equal to AC into root R into SF. According to Manning's equation, the discharge in gradually varied flow given by 1 by N wetted area A R power 2 by 3 SF power half. So check the differences between the discharge of water flow in gradually varied flow condition, the discharge of water flow in uniform flow condition in open channels. In uniform flow condition, we consider the channel bottom slope S naught in the Chesis equation and also in the Manning's equation. Whereas in gradually varied flow, we consider the total energy line slopes SF in the SEC equation or also in the Manning's equation. So this is the differences between the discharge of water flow equations in the uniform flow condition and in the gradually varied flow condition. So check these slopes modification. In the uniform flow condition, we consider the channel bottom slope S naught in the Chesney's equation and also in the Manning's equation. Whereas in gradually varied flow condition, in the Chesney's equation and also in the Manning's equation, we consider the slope of the total energy line SF. Now coming to the relationship between the water surface slopes. So check this carefully. The relation between water surface slopes and the channel bottom slope. Just now I explained, this is the water surface profile. Water surface profile in gradually varied flow. Dear students, everyone please follow this. In gradually varied flow, the water surface profile is having two types of slopes. Please everyone catch this carefully, very very important junction. In gradually varied flow, the water surface profile in the open channel is having two types of slopes. One is the slope with respect to channel bottom, dy by dx. With respect to inclined channel bottom, the slope of the water surface profile indicated as dy by dx. The next one is the slope of water surface profile with respect to horizontal, indicated as SW. So like that, in gradually varied flow, the water surface profile is having two types of slopes. One is the slope with respect to inclined channel bottom, dy by dx. Next one is the slope with respect to horizontal, SW. We are going to discuss what is the relationship between dy by dx slope, SW slope, and also the slope of the channel bottom, S naught. That is the discussion in the relationship between the water surface slope and the channel bottom slope. So please everyone follow this relation carefully. So already we discussed the dynamic equation in the gradually varied flow. According to the dynamic equation, dy by dx equal to S naught minus SF divided by 1 minus Q square T by GA cube. This is the dynamic equation in gradually varied flow. In this equation, dy by dx is the slope of the water surface profile with respect to channel bottom. The channel bottom is inclined channel bottom. So with respect to that inclined channel bottom, the slope of water surface profile indicated as dy by dx. The same water surface profile in gradually varied flow is having the another slope with respect to horizontal. With respect to horizontal, the slope of water surface profile in gradually varied flow indicated as SW. So please everyone catch these two slopes. We have two slopes in this discussion. One is the slope dy by dx. Next one is the slope SW. Can anybody answer what is dy by dx? Anybody in the class, give me the answer. What is dy by dx? Please give me the answer, anybody. What is dy by dx in dynamic equation?
AC root RI.
What is the dy by dx indicates? First give me, what is the dy by dx indicates? It is AC root RI. What is the dy by dx indicates? It is there in the slide. Please read that slide. What is the dy by dx called? Anybody in the class, give me the answer. What is this dy by dx called?
slope of water.
Check, 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 check this. Dy by dx represents the slope of the water surface profile with respect to
channel bottom.
With respect to channel bottom, the channel bottom is not horizontal. The channel bottom is inclined. So with respect to that inclined channel bottom, the slope of the water surface profile indicated as dy by dx. That is this dy by dx. So please switch off the mics. Continue. Please everyone switch off the mics. All of you switch off the mics. So in this dynamic equation, dy by dx called dy by dx indicates the slope of the water surface profile with respect to the inclined channel bottom. But this water surface profile is having the another slope with respect to horizontal. The channel bottom is not horizontal. Please catch that. The channel bottom is inclined. Channel bottom is not horizontal. With respect to that inclined channel bottom, the slope of the water surface profile indicated as dy by dx. But the same water surface profile is having the another slope with respect to horizontal. With respect to horizontal, the slope of the water surface profile indicated as SW. So the water surface profile in gradually varied flow is having two slopes. One is the slope dy by dx. Next one is the slope SW. The water surface profile in gradually varied flow is having two slopes. One is the slope dy by dx. Dy by dx is the slope of water surface profile with respect to the inclined channel bottom. The other slope is SW. SW is the slope of the water surface profile with respect to the horizontal. We are going to discuss the relation between dy by dx slope, SW slope, and also the channel bottom slope S naught. So everyone understand this relation between the water surface profile slopes dy by dx, SW. These two are the slopes of water surface profile. Dy by dx is the slope of the water surface profile with respect to channel bottom. SW is the slope of the water surface profile with respect to horizontal. And we have the another slope, the channel bottom slope S naught. We are going to discuss in the gradually varied flow the relationship between dy by dx slope, SW slope, and the slope S naught. So understand the relation carefully. So in this relationship, we have two conditions. The first condition, just now I explained, sometimes in the open channel, in gradually varied flow, in open channel, the depth of water flow gradually increases in downward direction. So that is first condition. We are going to discuss the relationship between dy by dx, SW, and S naught. We are going to discuss the relationship between dy by dx, SW, and S naught. If the water surface is a rising water surface, rising water surface means the depth of water flow gradually increasing along the direction of water flow. If the depth of water flow gradually increasing, so check these two sections carefully. At this section, depth of flow is y, whereas at this section, depth of flow is more. So this is the water level. This is the water surface profile. So here, the depth of flow is more when compared to the previous section. Here, this depth of flow is y at this section, whereas in the other section, depth of flow increases. Once that depth of flow increases in direction of flow, we call this water surface profile as the rising water surface. We are going to discuss the relationship between dy by dx slope, SW slope, and also the channel bottom slope S naught in this rising water surface condition. So check this diagram in the cell phone screens. So in this diagram, this is the channel bottom, the sloped channel bottom. The slope of the channel bottom is taken as S naught. Please everyone observe this. The slope of the channel bottom is S naught. Let this channel bottom, the inclined channel bottom with horizontal, making the angle theta. That theta is the angle made by the channel bottom with horizontal. The slope of the channel bottom is S naught. Along this channel bottom, consider the length of channel dx. Along this channel bottom, consider the length dx. At section 1, take y is the depth of water flow. This is the water surface profile. The line AB, please everyone watch this. The line AB indicates the water surface profile.
సరే వస్తున్నాను
రోల్ నెంబర్ 140
ఇందులో సరే వస్తున్నాను
మనం ఇంకా చెప్తే అందాక ఉంటది జ్యూట్ ఫుడ్ తాగిదాన్ని ఇందా మెన్న
So coming to this first condition, the water surface is the rising water surface. Rising water surface means the depth of flow increases in the direction of water flow. So check that diagram. In the diagram, along this water flow direction, downward direction, the depth of flow gradually increasing. So we are calling this water surface as the rising water surface. The line AB indicates the water surface profile. Along this water surface profile, the depth of flow increases. So we are calling it as the rising water surface in the relationship. So to discuss the relationship between dy by dx, sw and s naught, first we consider this condition one, the water surface in the channel is the rising water surface. Consider the length dx of the channel at a channel bottom. The channel bottom slope is S naught. With horizontal, the channel bottom is making the angle theta. So at this beginning of the section, depth of flow is Y. Whereas at the other section, the depth of flow, this is the depth of flow. From this bottom to this point B, that is the depth of flow, that is Y plus dy. So at this beginning, the depth of flow is Y. Whereas at this end, the depth of flow is y plus dy because this water surface is a rising water surface. Consider this dotted line AC. The dotted line AC is parallel to channel bottom. So this line AC indicates the channel bottom. Then consider this line AD. AD is the horizontal line. The line AC is parallel to channel bottom. The line AD is horizontal. Take this line AB. AB is the water surface profile. So in this diagram, the line AB indicates the water surface profile. The line AC is parallel to channel bottom. The line AD is horizontal. With respect to this horizontal, the channel bottom making the angle theta. So here, with respect to this horizontal AD, the line AC making the angle theta. And with respect to horizontal AD, this water surface profile AB making the angle alpha. Alpha is angle made by the water surface profile AB with horizontal. The angle made by AC with horizontal is theta. And in the diagram, we have different triangles. one is the triangle ABD. The triangle ABD, the next triangle ACD, the second triangle ACD, the third triangle ABC. So there are three triangles in the diagram. By using those three triangles, we are going to discuss the relationship between the slope dy by dx, the slope sw, and the slope s naught. So first we consider the rising water surface in the open channel. With respect to channel bottom, the slope of this water surface profile is dy by dx. With respect to horizontal, the slope of this water surface profile is sw. So this is sw, the slope of this water surface profile with respect to horizontal, and the channel bottom slope is s naught. We are going to discuss the relationship between the slope s naught, the slope of this water surface profile dy by dx, and the slope sw. So we are going to discuss the relationship by using this diagram. So check the diagram carefully. In the diagram we have three triangles. One is the triangle, right angle triangle ABD. Next one is the right angle triangle ACD. Third one is the triangle ABC. By using those three triangles, we are going to discuss the relationship between dy by dx, sw, and s naught. So check this explanation carefully. S naught, the slope of the channel bottom with horizontal. So s naught is the slope of the channel bottom with respect to horizontal. Dy by dx, the slope of the water surface profile. Water surface profile is AB. Dy by dx is the slope of the water surface profile with respect to channel bottom. Sw, the slope of the water surface profile with respect to horizontal. We are going to prepare the relationship between these three slopes, S naught, dy by dx, and Sw. To prepare the relationship, first consider the triangle ABD. So take that triangle ABD. In the diagram I explained, take the triangle first, ABD, this triangle. In this ABD triangle, this is a right angle triangle. ABD is a right angle triangle. In that triangle, tan alpha is equal to adjacent side, opposite side BD divided by adjacent side AD. So in this right angle triangle, ABD, tan alpha. Alpha is the angle made by the water surface profile AB with horizontal. So tan alpha equal to the slope SW. SW is the slope of this water surface profile with horizontal. That SW is equal to tan alpha, because this water surface AB with horizontal making the angle alpha, tan alpha is equal to SW, that is equal to opposite side is BD divided by adjacent side is AD. But in the diagram, the length AD is approximately equal to the length AB. In the diagram, the length AD, because it is a small triangle, the length AD is equal to approximately equal to AB. The length BD, I can write this length BD is equal to the length CD. The length BD is the length CD minus the length CB. So take this right angle triangle ADB first. In that right angle triangle ADB, tan alpha is equal to SW, that is equal to opposite side BD divided by adjacent side AD. The length AD is equal to the length AB. So check this carefully. First we consider the triangle ABD. In that triangle, the slope SW. What is that SW? The slope of the water surface profile with respect to horizontal. SW is equal to tan alpha, that is equal to BD by AD. BD is the opposite side, AD is the adjacent side. But this AD length approximately equal to AB, the length BD equal to CD minus CB. So tan alpha or SW is equal to BD equal to CD minus CB divided by AB. Separate the terms on the right side. So SW equal to CD by AB minus CB by AB. Take this as equation 1. So in that condition 1, first we consider the right angle triangle ABD. From that right angle triangle ABD, we write this SW, the slope of the water surface profile with respect to horizontal, CD by AB minus CB by AB. Then consider in the previous diagram, the next triangle ACD. The second triangle in the previous diagram, the triangle ACD. So in this diagram, take this right angle triangle ACD. In this right angle triangle ACD, AC is parallel to channel bottom, and this line AC with horizontal making the angle theta. So tan theta is equal to the slope of the line AC, that is also equal to slope of the channel bottom S naught. So in this triangle ACD, tan theta is equal to slope of the line AC, but AC is parallel to channel bottom. So this tan theta equal to the slope S naught. Tan theta equal to opposite side is CD. CD is the opposite side and AD is the adjacent side. So tan theta equal to CD by AD, but AD equal to approximately equal to AB. So you can write tan theta equal to CD divided by AB. So here in that next second condition, we consider the triangle ACD. In that triangle ACD, tan theta is equal to the slope of the line AC, but AC is parallel to channel bottom. So tan theta is equal to slope of the channel bottom S naught, that is equal to opposite side is CD, adjacent side is AD, but the length AD approximately equal to AB. So S naught equal to CD by AB. Then from the third triangle ABC, take this third triangle ABC. In that third triangle ABC, check this third triangle. So in the third triangle, this water surface profile is making some angle with this line AC. The line AC parallel to channel bottom. So you can consider this line AC as the channel bottom. So this is AB, water surface profile. The slope of this water surface profile AB with respect to channel bottom AC is written as dy by the length dx. So check this triangle ABC. In the triangle ABC, AB is the water surface profile, AC is the channel bottom. So the slope of this water surface profile AB with respect to channel bottom AC is dy by dx. Dy is the length CB, dx is the length AC. We know that with respect to this channel bottom, the slope of the water surface profile is dy by dx, that you can observe in the triangle ABC. So from the triangle ABC, dy by dx is equal to CB divided by AB. So by considering that third triangle ABC, you can write dy by dx equal to CB by AB. So check this carefully. CB by AB equal to dy by dx. CB by AB equal to CD by AB equal to S naught, and in the equation 1, SW equal to CD by AB. What is this CD by AB? S naught. What is this CB by AB? DY by DX. So substitute those equation 2 and equation 3. What is the equation 2? CD by AB equal to S naught. What is the equation 3? CB by AB equal to DY by DX. Substitute these two equations in equation 1, you will get the equation 1, SW equal to CD by AB is S naught, CB by AB is DY by DX. So you will get the relationship as, by substitution of equation 2 and equation 3 in equation 1, SW equal to S naught minus DY by DX. So in the gradually varied flow, if the water surface profile is a rising water surface profile, then the relationship between the slope dy by dx, the slope sw, and the slope s naught in the condition of rising water surface in gradually varied flow, the relationship is sw equal to s naught minus dy by dx. In that equation 4, s naught, the channel bottom slope, dy by dx, the slope of the water surface profile with respect to channel bottom, SW, the slope of the water surface profile with respect to horizontal. So this is the first condition in the relationship between SW, S naught, and dy by dx when the water surface is a rising water surface. Okay student, with this I am going to stop the class. Please attend the class regularly, because this subject is a very, very difficult subject. Then in the next class, we will continue. The second condition, when the water surface is a falling water surface, that equation 4 is a rising water surface. SW equal to S naught minus dy by dx. What about the relationship between S naught, SW and dy by dx? If the water surface is a falling water surface, I will continue this discussion in the next class. Please join the third one in the online session. With this, I am going to stop the class. I will continue this discussion in next class. So please join the third one in online session.